on this one. On this one here, that's exactly what happening. When you come in here, and then what happening is somebody come along attacking you. Make sure the honey line control and then moving. So you control this on here. As you've been practicing on the phone, learn to control and attack.
Hi everyone, it's Master Wong here. Today, again, it's another beautiful day onto the Wing Chun for self-defense. Basic and simple. Okay, this lesson here, I will go through with you the basic movement onto the block and then control them onto the side, force them into the wall and attack them. Now, a lot of time you will see I go like this to the person a lot onto the back, control them. Because when you're in this situation, it's very difficult for them to try to force it back. You control them, okay? Keep your distance, keep your weapon available, because you need to use all this weapon. Without this weapon, you cannot make the movement work, okay? Now, some of you watching for this and get excited and want to follow along, you see on here, hit the subscribe button and you see the little bell here, do some on some Wing Chun on it. So make sure that the bell is ring. So that way, when I upload a new video, you get it into your inbox right away. So you never miss the lesson onto the Wing Chun training for self-defense, okay? And another thing as well, while I'm here, some of you are asking a lot of different questions. The question again is right in the end of this video. So that way it's easy for me to answer. So let's get into some of the movement. As you know, onto the lesson last week, your practice on the movement when somebody kick, like the front kick you, okay? Or the straight kick you on here, you need to move. This kick here, it doesn't matter low or high, okay? The principle of this movement, okay, is the same on it, okay? So that way it become a lot more easier for you if it here or if it here. But in this situation, somebody come into round kick. Now, certainly, as you move it, you're walking, bam, you practice this movement onto the form a lot, okay, onto the Wing Chun training side. On this movement, when you practice onto the form, you need to learn to using your ways, okay? But the most important thing about practice this movement here is your wrist, okay, to make sure absorb and move, absorb onto the movement and then move, okay? Because certainly, bam, move. And then now, it's important to learn about the Wing Chun stepping, because you are forcing forward and push your enemy into the object, okay? Now, need to understand, this is designed for self-defense. Because it's designed for self-defense, you have to think in the street. Because if you don't think in the street, you're thinking this is the open space for you to learn to move. It's a big problem. Obstacle everywhere. So what you do is you're using surrounding to helping you. This is our training hub. Know yourself, know your enemy, know your ability, and know your surrounding. Okay? So to learn at this, practice with me on the movement, then the hand, okay, on here, like this. Turn, practice this face. It's very basic and simple onto the movement, like this, okay? Now, when you practice, use your waist, okay? Use your waist, your hand, and your wrist. When you're attacking, you've got to learn to condition it. So that's where you're learning onto the training program that I provide for you. They have the wrist, the training, the conditioning, so you know how to use it. When some object come in, like you can use it to up here. So you can use it to block, you can use it for the kick, you can use it all different way. And then that way become a lot more easier for you to move and then go forward. Again, principle the same, attack, attack, attack. Because this hand, as you go through, you practice onto the elbow. So the principle like same, last time the same. If you round kick, move, you go forward as same. This hand attacking as you grabbing. As that go, you are attacking the rib cage round the back and keep the distance and the leg. So you force him into the wall, okay? Sooner than that, you can have both hands ready, elbow to the back of the collarbone around here, okay? And then you push him and move out of the way. Because a lot of time, the self-defense side, you're not here to choke them, tear their head off, fisheye them and all sort of stuff. We will talk a lot about dirty, nasty stuff as we go through the lesson, as you progress. First into the training side, it's going to be difficult for you to learn and think like that. You've got to gradually build them in, okay? So turn, move forward. Soon you move forward, this is where the Wing Chun hand is. Have to keep your hand this way. Keep it distant. When your hand is here, attack. This attack, as you are practice, remember, bam, 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 and attack it, bam, bam, elbow. Remember all this basic movement, the mechanics that you do. You have to practice this over, over, over again. Because certainly I'm talking, certainly move, okay? I control and I'm attacking. I'm launching my attack right away, okay? Control the arm, and then move, control the hand here, and then attack right away. You have to think like this to be able to work. Because when you're outside, certain things happen all the time, and you won't be able to understand it. This is where it goes to surprise, speed, and violent of action, okay? So when you're learning this movement here, using your ways to turn, sooner move, twist, okay? Sooner hand, twist. This is basic movement, okay? On here, like movement. So when you turn, you twist, then you follow, okay? Sooner block here, you twist, because you want to using this to move your enemy feet out of the way, and then go forward. Because when they're kicking so hard on in, you've got to absorb very well. Otherwise, your wrist will broken right away, okay? And you will have a lot of questions. You will have a lot of different questions about this, a lot of questions about that. Remember, comment below here so I will be able to answer you. And watching through the end of this video, so I have question and answer and also competition for you to enter to practice with me to learn from me. That will become a lot more easier, because a lot of time it's learning about the mindset to understanding in the street how it works, how everything is. Okay, so when you practice this movement here at home, turn hand, when you practice Wing Chun, you have to think something happened, my hand here, something happened, my hand here. That's why you see when I'm talking, my hand like this all the time. Okay, something happened, something. I respond to the movement right away. Because in the street, certain things happen, I have to respond very quickly. I cannot just think where the movement is. Okay, so this is why it's important to learn, know about how you're using your body to able to make it work for you. Okay, so turn, move forward, attack, elbow, elbow, I'm coming in. Okay, bang, here, move, go forward, grab, pin it in, force him into the wall, bam, 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 here. Then elbow, bam, 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 elbow, one, one, and then you can get rid of them and you run away. This is quite important to understand, okay? Without this, big problem. So here, the lesson, now practice, and right to the end, and I have a question and answer for you. Later.
On to the tip on this particular module, level one here. On this one. On this one here, that's exactly what happening. When you come in here, and then so what happening is somebody come along attacking you. Make sure the hand in line, control, and then moving. So you control this arm here. As you've been practicing on the form, learn to control and attack. Hand here, like with you in the form. Okay, this is important. If you're blocking this hand on this particular movement here, we're talking about, if you're not in control, you get a problem. So sooner here, put that, and then bring him in here, and attacking, attacking, attacking on that straight away to hurt them. Okay, think of that. So the basic movement on this particular tip here is learning to understand when you're walking, learn to have your hand in the position like you do in the form. So you know exactly what's happening and respond to it. So this is very important. If you don't, you're gonna have a problem.
Okay, did you love the movement that you're walking in? Certainly you need to defend and control and you go back to attack. Now, this is very important to learn to understand. This is by surprise. Somebody certainly coming in, you need to get used to move, okay? Move and control, move and control. So the hand you practice on to the Wing Chun training is very, very good using for self-defense. In this self-defense training, that will helping you to get you to understanding, to be aware where your hand is surrounding. As you're watching full one of the lesson, you see, if you some of you haven't watched it, you see, I'm walking certain behind. So you have to be able to defend your body, and then elbow, okay, and then elbow. Also, the moment you see somebody grab you, you need to attack straight away, and then you see the sitting down, you got to work. So all this movement here, as you progress through the journey with me into the Wing Chun self-defense, is many, many things that can use into the self-defense in real time. So it's helping you to learn, okay? So that's what you need to know. Any questions that I want to ask, ask below here, and I will answer on here for you, okay? So I will answer some of the questions here, and then we're going to talk about the competition again. How to defend against a ground and pound on the ground. As you learn and see into the training side, a lot of time I've told you before when you're training, keep yourself small because all this movement is need to cover here. Whatever you do here, it have to be here. Because when you go down the ground, they're going to smack you. And if your hand out here, you're not defending the face. Okay, I have a lot of lessons on that onto the channel as well. So get used to that. So when you go down the ground, you automatically cover your face. This is why you see your hand come up like this. It's designed for all this, up, down. You're using the same principle. So that way, if something happens, you don't need to think where is your hand. It's here. Okay, coming here, 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 defending. And then you start to move to able to defend that. So this is very important to understand. The way you do anything is the way you do everything. One particular training or method of the hand can cross over to many, many different things. As is the same way, if I'm going out, certain attack, I have my hand here. It needed to be defended either way. So it's no different if I'm down the ground, I need to be defending my head, my body. That's why the movement, when you practice the form, okay, you have to make sure, not like this a lot, keep your hand upright and in line. So your body in line. So you have to bring this chest in. Same thing like somebody grab you. You have to put it chest in. So when you go down the ground, you have to go like this. You can't go like this, okay? Because it loose, got empty space, they're going to smack you. You got to close everything down, okay? Hope that answered the question for you, okay? Somebody said, Master Wong, I am number one. Support always. Active when you upload video. Wing Chun technique is unique. That's very good. Keep practice and watching. Like I say a lot, watching and practice. Every day you do little bit of practice every day. That will helping you to getting better. Little bit better than nothing. Okay. Watching, if I do in a movement, you practice just something to get you called a muscle memory. The body can be worked for you as you go forward, because otherwise when something happens you don't know what to do because your body is very alien to you. You're not able to remember what to respond to the movement because your body is frozen. Okay, so practice, that's very interesting. Keep watching and practice. Okay, somebody said here, Ray, a big guy in front of us with the pick on a small guy, advises and pick on a small guy. You get a lot of people, like big people pick on the small people. What do you do? Reality term is bigger, they always got advantage of the smaller person. It's no doubt about that, okay? So you need to learn to understanding, need to be more play dirty. That's why we have our motto, train hard, live clean, and fight dirty. So when they pick on him, let's boom to the nut there, smack to the nut here, kick into the nut here, straight to the throat like this. And when he grab hold of you, try to attack it, defending, smack in the hand into the eyeball. This is why this guy said, boom to the eye like this. You have to play dirty. When somebody bigger than you, you have to play dirty. If you're watching the how to fight the bully, I will talk a lot about my experience in Vietnam. You have to fight dirty. Okay, when you're in that situation. So if you read a book or you're watching that, you will see a lot of time I will talk to you a lot about that. At next week, every week, they have every so on. So I talk to each of the chapter. You got no choice but fight dirty, okay? So you got to train to get yourself in line, okay? Make sure you eat clean, so you look after yourself. Don't do drugs. Don't do alcohol too much. Little bit could be good. And 5:30, something happened. You're losing because you're not strong enough. They're bigger than you. Then you got to play dirty. You know, onto the eyeball here, grabbing a nut here, smack on the throat here. This is the free thing. Eye, throat, and a groin. It works every time. Okay? Next one. One more then. How to defend when your opponent gives you many punch. Okay. How to defend when your opponent like give you many punch. How to defend? Learn to cover up. Okay. Learn to cover your face. Bam bam. See you attacking? Cover. Boom boom. Cover. You need to cover all this hand up on your face from here to short. Because if you don't, they're gonna decorate your face. Because all they're interested in is smack you in the face. So you got to learn to defend the hand. Okay, the hand. That's why attacking movement, defend, and keep the eye. Because that's what they are. Keep your hand up here. Attacking, come back, and use that as a method. If it not, you got a problem. All this thing here is on our training program and teach you as you progress, as you learning. Okay, so a lot of that on our website here. Now, we've done onto the question here. Let's get into the competition side. If you see any of your friends love Wing Chun and learn and watching and interesting, all you got to do is just share this video to three of your friends. Okay, three of your friends. And then after when you've done that, come to our website called masterwong.tv. Okay, going down. And then go on the message on the corner there, the message. Click on the message and then send me the message on there. Tell me three things you love about
message
Wing Chun.
Message me from
okay,
here.
Three things you love about Wing Chun. And I comment you back and talk to you full end. And then I will tell you if the, what you're saying. And I will tell you to give me some little more detail about yourself. And then I will update you as we go forward on it. Okay. So that's what is it we need to do. Very basic and simple. Anything else you want to do, then you can check out our website. And you're watching me like I take all the time. If you like to know what I'm taking and I'm able to helping for daily training and mind, body, and spirit and stuff like that, I'm using stuff called Silly Chip. Okay, go there, go to my website, click below, and then go there and get it some and check it out. And make sure on the checkout using the Master Wong, the code to get some discount. That will helping you drink free time, helping you to get your mind, body, and spirit more clearly, more better, more energy, so you can able to do all the things you need to do. Okay, so that's important. Check out the website. They got all the clothes there, everything there. Click on it and go and get some for it. Okay, I also have all the training program there for you as well, so you can check out what is suitable for you and then go from there. If any more question you want to ask me from this video. If you want to ask me personally on certain thing, then go to my website and message me and ask me personally. I will be here to answer your questions. Okay, so take it easy and I will see you on to probably on a Thursday or maybe Tuesday, maybe Sunday. Which one is it? I'm not sure yet. So keep an eye and make sure watching the Tai Chi one as well and also the how to fight a bully. I talk about a lot into that so you can learn a lot and understand about experience. So Master Wong here, speak to you later. Out.